Hello everyone, myself Professor Jinal Nayak, working as an assistant professor at SNPIT and RC Umrakh Bardoli. Here I am going to discuss about the topic geometric mean from the subject probability and statistics. Basically, geometric mean is a measure of central tendency. When data consist of percentage, ratios, growth rates, or other rates of change, the geometric mean is a useful measure of central tendency. The geometric mean is not used if any of the observations is given negative. If one of the observations is zero, the geometric mean for that data set will be zero. Now, we see the classification of data. The data can be classified as ungrouped type data and grouped type data. Ungrouped type data is also known as raw data. And group data, that means one observations interval wise. Now, ungroup type data can be also classified as data without frequencies and data with given frequencies. Now we see how to find geometric mean for all these type of data. We start with geometric mean for ungrouped data. When ungrouped data is given without frequency, its geometric mean can be defined as the nth root of product of all the n observations. That means geometric mean equals nth root of product of all given n observations. Suppose we are given x1, x2 up to xn, total n observations, then the geometric mean will be this. When we are given total number of observations in small number, we can find geometric mean using this formula directly. But if sometimes the number of observations is given in large number, it is tedious to calculate geometric mean using this formula directly. Now we see how to calculate the geometric mean when the data is given in large number. If n observations xi are given in large number, then the geometric mean can be calculated by taking logarithm on both the sides of the equation. This geometric mean is equal to product of all the observations and nth root of it. Then we have to make some simplification using properties of logarithm to obtain the desired formula for geometric mean. We will do these steps and ultimately we will have the formula of geometric mean. In the last step, we have to consider antilog of summation log x upon n to obtain the geometric mean when ungrouped type data without frequency are given in large number. Now we see the geometric mean for ungrouped data with given frequencies. If for n observations x1, x2 up to xn with frequencies f1, f2 up to fn respectively, the geometric mean is given by this formula. Here, xi to the power fi and product of all these terms and their capital nth root will be the geometric mean. Here capital N is the total number of frequencies, that is the sum of all the frequencies. So this is the formula to find geometric mean for ungrouped data with given frequencies. Here I want to explain one more thing, that if small n is not a very large number, we can directly calculate the geometric mean using the formula. Now we see the method of calculation. Same as the previous concept, if the ungrouped data with frequencies are given in large number, we have to consider logarithm on both the sides of the equation. Geometric mean equals x1 to the power f1 up to the product xn to the power fn and its nth root. Here there are given total small n observations xi with respective frequencies fi. Now when we take logarithm on both the sides, again we have to make some simplification steps to get desired formula. And according to the properties, we can get the formula geometric mean is equal to antilog of summation I1 to n fi into ln xi upon capital N. Here capital N is total frequencies. So this is the formula to find geometric mean when ungrouped data is given in large number. Now we see the geometric mean for group data. Whenever we see that group data, that means given observations are in interval form. So for group data with given frequency, the geometric mean can be calculated using the formula this. Here m1, m2 up to mn are the mean values of all the intervals and capital N is sum of the frequencies. Now we see the method of calculation for group data. For calculation, we have to take logarithm on both the sides of the equation. Geometric mean is equal to this. Here capital N is total number of frequencies. By taking logarithm on both the sides and by applying properties of logarithm, we get this form 1 upon n into f1 log m1 plus up to fn log mn. And by taking antilog, we will get the formula for geometric mean. In this formula, capital N is summation of frequency, that is total number of frequencies, and mi, that is mean value of each interval. I hope you understand the topic well. Thank you.